time for the little people, all the wood food, everyone, all the family. All right, and you man's in the studio. All
right, go with you. All
right, man. I'm going to read a poem now, all right?
All right.
Okay, can you hear me properly?
Yeah, cool, yeah.
All right. Sorry, girls, the world is not a pleasant place to be without someone to hold, someone to be held. A river would not stop its flow if only a stream were there to receive it. An ocean would never laugh if clouds weren't there to kiss her tears. The world is not a pleasant place to be without someone. Bless. That's it.
One more time, repeat that.
Pardon?
Repeat that.
Repeat that again.
Speaking of the sound effects behind.
Okay, the title of the poem, I know it doesn't sound too happy, but the title of the poem is called The World Is Not a Pleasant Place to Be. Okay? So it goes, the world is not a pleasant place to be without someone to hold and be held by. A river would stop its flow if only a stream were there to receive it. An ocean would never laugh if clouds weren't there to kiss her tears. The world is not a pleasant place to be without someone.
That was good, man. And it, you can send the next one in as well, you know.
Yeah.
I got more, man.
I'll
call you later.
All right, then.
Cool.
All right, bless.
Hey, big up, man. Big up all the crew. Big up all the staff in Liverpool. Doctor. And the phone line number 079-444-313-66. Signs of the Blessed 1067. Shout out to Venetia. Coming through with some smart texts. Right, text read. Guys, I'm a first time listener to the station. I'm not a singer. Nor am I an MC. But I'm a student at Luton University. Okay. That rhymes, you know, bro.
That's a poem, isn't it?
She never wrote that. I just made it up, anyway. She's not a singer. She's from Luton University and she wants to know what's the name of the station.
Bless.
FM. 106.7.
Bless FM.
Yeah, that.
It's Bless FM. Alright, it's Bless FM 106.7.
Yeah. Can you text in? Where are you calling? Where's she calling from?
Luton University.
Luton.
And where's she called? Where's she calling from?
No, she never said.
Okay.
079-444-313-66. And if you didn't get it because you was too busy doing something, or you was in the toilet, or you just woke up, it's Bless FM 106.7. Baby, I know it's a shame. To the person who just texted in from Luton University, can you text us your name and where you're calling from? Shout out to a big team. Right, here's a question here for all those listeners for the Luton University Massive.
Everyone,
all the listeners. It's a good question. The question is, why are so many black youths underachieving and only 9% of boys or black boys are achieving compared to the 55 of white boys? And that's a fact, you know.
Hey, say that again.
We want to know. Say it again in English. Question is, Venetia said basically,
yeah,
why are black male youngsters underachieving? Like, and the fact is that there's 9% of black males, young males, achieving compared to the 55% of white males.
why ain't they achieving?
Yeah, why are the black males
not achieving? Are you achieving?
Yeah, of course.
Are you achieving, Jayla?
What do you say?
Well,
take off your coat, man. It's too hot. No, I mean, what?
Man's got his proper jacket on. Okay. Man, the cold-blooded man, you know. With it like this. Okay, we got the puffer jacket crew inside the studio.
Woo!
Man, tell you. Got a cup of tea. Okay, alright. So, the question is, yeah,
why are black male youngsters, why are black youths underachieving?
It's an opinion, really, isn't it?
Yeah.
Bless. Are you doing that topic? About black people
on the
choosing.
Yes,
which is a text that came in, so we read it out. So, what's your opinion?
I think so. That's like everything they use the statistics to like amplify a good sort of message. Firstly, black and ethnicity people are sort of like a minority. So, if they dig the seed in school, like the statistics will not be like as high. With my counterpart, and like if you go to any college game, especially when it's black or something, you'll find that a lot of students are black themselves.
Yeah.
But you know, when it comes to like ethnicity, like apart from white people who come first from being successful, black people are second, and it's Pakistani and Bangladeshi people who are doing really, really terrible. But black people are being amplified and being brainwashed into believing that they're failing, but they're not, because they're doing really, really well.
I agree with that. I agree with what you say. I think
it's but I can't hear you properly, you know.
Okay, hold on, I'll help you out.
He says that he agrees with what you just said.
I agree with what you just said.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's a brainwashed thing. I think it's a majority of it is a brainwashed thing to make the black youths then think that they're not achieving. Yeah? But they are achieving. Look at the music industry now, yeah?
Even sports, if you look at most sports.
All right, the music industry.
Or media.
Right now, the black music, what's coming out, the R&B, the hip-hop, that's what's holding up the music thing.
Well, black music, because you see with the media, big slogans with, you know, pictures, you know, that, you know, to sort of give it a difference, yeah?
Yeah.
You can say that, oh, that's a new crime, but that's absolutely cool.
You're breaking up a bit, you know?
What?
Your phone's breaking up a little bit.
What?
Your phone's breaking up a little bit.
Oh.
Can you just repeat what you said?
What I'm saying is that with crime, am I breaking up?
No, you're right.
I'm saying, with crime as well, is that the media can amplify it. So if a black person done a crime, they'll say, oh, this and that, and but make sure that, you know, it's mentioned that he's black and sort of put a spit on it.
Yeah.
But then, like, you know, a lot of black communities are like kind of criticize other black men, but that's not true, because that little Huntley man, weren't he white? A lot of people, most pedophiles are white, and they don't say nothing to them. It's that, but I'm saying that black people are brainwashed into going against other black people, sort of thing, and they're trying to say them music to stuff, which is not mainly the music, because you can turn around and can criticize rock just as equally.
That's
Am I breaking
point.
Up?
No, that was a good point. So what's your name? Where you calling from?
Make up a name and just say where you're calling from.
What?
What's your name and where you're calling from?
Silas.
From?
Yeah.
Where from?
Tottenham.
Okay.
You can say Eve, Love is Blind.
Okay.
After that speech, you deserve it, you know.
Yeah, Tree say, well, special girl, innit?
Huh?
What?
Lady Special, no,
it's not the same person.
You can play Love is Blind because my credits is getting rich.
Alright, I want to play that for you, yeah?
Alright.
But thank you, made a good last caller, you made a good point. And boy, it's appreciated, you know, because
we need to know what you think
That's
as well. And the family needs to know, because sometimes there's questions that they need to ask. and maybe one of you will come up with the answer for them as well. So the debate is, do you think that the black male is underachieving? More or less, that's the debate, isn't it?
Yeah. What text reads.
And if so, why? And if not, why?
Right, text reads. It's the system, yeah? It's not. It's the individual thing. Think black boys, it's the individual that think black boys have to try harder. It, in every aspect of life, it's not fair. That's coming from Hattie up in Luton University, yeah? Right, Hattie. Where you calling from, yeah? Where are you listening to right now? Where are you listening to us from? But once again, 079-444-31366.
I know I spoke before, but it's probably about, you know, I'm curious how I'm hearing anyone else that bad fuck self. Basically, black people aren't educated, especially from nursing, like, kind of...
You're breaking up, you know, you're breaking up.
I'm on.
Go on, say that again.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
If I'm saying, like, especially if it's worse for black people, it's even worse. Because, like, if you go, like, to anywhere, like, with me, yeah, okay, it's black people, you kind of, you know, blend in a little bit, but for black people, you know, it's so difficult. Because this is nursing school, yeah, because the white teachers and other teachers, they'll kind of, like, make the black young, you know, sort of, like, alienated, so then they kind of, you know, forced to believe that, you know, they're in a classroom and they're humiliated in the classroom. Like, a lot of the boys, you know, they get, like, you know, use the scapegoats, really. You get me?
We don't.
What? Well, it's not all of them who use a scapegoat. Some of them, most probably.
Yeah, because one day, yeah, you see, one day you can have, like, two different kids, one white kid and one black kid run off, yeah, on a school trip, yeah, and then they both come back, here. Yeah. You see, the black kid, yeah, will get worse, the white kid, you probably get, you know, nothing, because anything, so it's the black child who led them to it, you get it? And black kids, most often, they're dangerous and encouraged, because when I was in school, yeah, it was like, oh my God, it was like the black kids, you can blatantly see in the teacher's eyes, blatantly racist, but you know, you have to, but then black people also have to understand you, that you're the minority, and if you don't, but if you don't, and if, am I breaking up?
No.
And if you think that the education system is bad enough, what you need to do, yeah, is if you don't believe it, you need to go through it, yeah, to teach your, you know, future kids to get it and not let them be in the hands of them big fat racists. Pardon?
Nothing.
No, we're listening.
Yeah, I think I've said enough, you know.
Okay.
I don't want to stop anyone from getting through.
No. We've got some points, bro.
What I'm saying. I'm like, to a certain extent, yeah, even though all this discrimination stuff has to motivate you to a certain extent. And then other black people who they do have that successful. What? Say something.
No.
Am I breaking up?
No.
And then other people who do have are successful, you're often the black people who do not actually represent the, you know, the streets or anything. You understand what I'm talking about? They have, like, posh accents. Right. And, you know, it's that tokenism. Do you know what tokenism is?
No, go on, tell us.
No.
Basically, tokenism is that where they might feature one black person to avoid being called racist. You understand me? What?
All right.
What's your name and where you calling from? I haven't finished what I'm saying yet.
No, but I just want to know, innit? Because you're making valuable points and they're good. So, what's your name?
Sally.
Sally?
Yeah.
From Tottenham. But yeah, go through. Go on, finish what you say.
All I'm saying is that, you know, the off thing, you know, those black people don't represent the streets and stuff. You know, when you're talking about black people, do you know the other black people who might say that, oh, black people aren't achieving because it's their fault and all of this, you know, like, they can't really say why those streets from the ghettos are staying, are sort of having those problems, you know, unless they're from the ghettos themselves. You understand me?
Yeah.
Right.
Like, you can't tell a rich child can't speak for like a poor child. Do you get me?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll finish.
See.
Okay, good points, some valuable points, and everybody's got their point of view still. So, family, what do you think about what she just said? Yeah. 079-444-313-66.
Bless.
Yeah, and I have to say also one thing, yeah. Often it's the fathers as well, it's the mostly. Maybe the fathers might be absent. What? Say something.
No.
Go on.
Often, yeah, the fathers might be absent as well.
Yeah.
Like, fathers, because just like how any child, yeah, it's like in the mothers as well. Often, yeah, it's like, it's maybe like the parents had them when they were young and, you know, it might be psychological, might not be fit enough to look after because it's, you know, what socialization is.
Go on, tell us.
You know what it is?
Friction. No, tell us.
Okay, socialization is the process by which a child learns its norms and values of that culture. So, you know, if a child is not socialized within a community properly, do you understand me? So, you know, it does not naturally behave properly.
Oh, right.
In a way. But if the parents just going out taking drugs, you know, and that often, that's how many black children start with drugs, like, you know, young little kids taking weed and the parents take it, so then it's just sort of acceptable.
Like the PlayStation and thing.
What?
That's how the PlayStation kicks in, isn't it? Because it makes them a bit violent.
Yeah, and plus, you see in little ghettos, yeah, it's like, it's all about, you know, the bling bling and the night and all of this, you know, and what's it, the Avericks, do you get me? Other than the school books, in a way, the sort of socialization process, it's like, you know, referred to duration, which means that you're living for now, not for the future. If you go to most of the ghetto kids, oh, what are you going to do in the year 2030? You're going to go, huh? You understand what I'm saying? It's like socialization. Yeah. Like, you know, the parents who get socialization well enough, you know, to think, you know, or, you know, just bang it, because in 10 years, tomorrow I might get hit over by a car. And often, black kids do suffer badly, yeah, because, like, the parents, the mum and dad might be poor or something here, yeah, and they might be selling drugs here, yeah, because that's the only way they can get quick and instant money. You know, when they do have criminal records, where can they go? I'm sorry if I'm talking. No, carry on.
You're making good points.
Carry on, because I will
be. It has to be said, because in the Austin, yeah, I'm seeing, like, you see, when I'm walking through the streets, yeah, a lot of black women have bad tempers, yeah, but I'm there, I can't say a lot of black women, but black people are only minority, so then I can turn around and say, okay, a lot of black women, but, you know, always be mobbed. Huh? Did you say something?
No,
we're listening.
But all I'm saying is that when I go through the street, I saw some black woman here just beating a child here. The child must have been 6 years old. Say, get up, but think about it. How would you like getting beaten like that? If you saw the child getting beaten up here, you're thinking, you know, how's the child going to grow up properly? Because it's part of the socialization process, isn't it? It's getting hit like that. So it's either the son's going to grow up here thinking it's okay to hit women, or he's going to grow up a bit like chichi, like, you know, like he's just so weak, to get it? He's going to let people step over him. So if he's going to get criticized at school, he's going to abandon school. And they look for stuff, yeah, especially gangs. That's why gangs are so strong, because unlike, because if the family members ain't that strong, you see what that's two different things. You either have the family or the friends, you understand me? If your friends abandon you, you can always go to your family, but if your family abandon you, you can go to your friends, sort of thing. So that's like a most gang bonds are better than family bonds, and those people in gangs have been abused. I'm not going to sit there and criticize the black community, because the black community are only a minority, whereas the white community are a majority. And you cannot sit there and pinpoint black people unless I should sit there and pinpoint white people, because most paedophiles are white. And in case you don't know, a lot of black people don't know this, yeah, you know, to be anyone can be an MP. You don't need no qualifications to be an MP. I'm not doing that. You see, often you don't really vote and educate these black kids and say, you know what, you see, the teachers do put black kids down. And I've been put down throughout secondary school. I know that I'm not going to go, well, you know, no matter what the teacher says, because then they're probably chatting out the arse, yeah. But no matter what they say, yeah, it's just what they're saying. But it's not going to be, you know, it's their words, not against your future. Do you understand me? But that's just probably because, you know, I would say I'm not really a strong person, but I would say, you know, I wouldn't say I'm determined, yeah, but I would just say, you know, I'm more futuristic than everyone. Like, you know, most people might be looking for the present to get it. Think, oh, I can't stand this bullying, or just let me go and work for a year or something. Do you understand me?
Right.
And I'm thinking, no, the quicker I stay in here, then the quicker I do a law degree, then, you know, the quicker I can be, you know, let me see, just a lawyer or something. Do you understand me?
Yeah.
So, a lot of times, you know, and then it's sort of thing, then when the girls do get pregnant, yeah, is that often a lot of the girls keep the babies here because, no offense, it's silly enough to believe that the boy's going to stay with them. Now, that's not true. You see, a lot of black girls have to be educated because, you know, I'm not trying to disrespect black men or nothing, but a lot of them are good and stuff, yeah. But I'm saying, though, yeah, some girls always consider abortion, yeah, because I'm saying, okay, if you can't look after yourself, yeah, like, what if the child's 24/7, yeah, you can't handle the charge, yeah. You're gonna go crazy if you don't understand, yeah, that when you ain't well, yeah, the child can feel that you're not well. Like, if you're really depressed over money, yeah, the child's gonna feel it, and then the child, yeah, often might want to help you out of the situation by either going to steal, sell stuff. You get it?
Yeah.
That's how most often children do get this. I'm going to say black people are doing very well for themselves, and we should not be having debates like this. We should be having debates about why black people are being, why black people, yeah, are being unfairly portrayed within the media, because that's what they try to do. They try to use stuff like this, yeah, to separate other black people. The black people who have got, like, you know, decent jobs there, because there's black people are disgraced. No black person is a disgrace. It's only the things that you say to other people. It's only once you start turning your back on other black people. Now, that's disgraceful, because if these things of these black people have all this money, and most of white people ain't going to help you, why don't these black people, you start giving their money out? Because what these white media start to do, if I do stuff like this, you create barriers and dividers, or the good black people than the bad black people. But these, a lot of people are too blind to stop and open their eyes, because to us, it might be good black people and bad black people, but to white people, it's just all black people. But that's like when you have to stop and, like, just totally go. I think everyone's going to sleep. Totally go against it all. What?
No, nothing.
No.
That was a good point you made.
Good point, but we hear your points, yeah? But me personally, I'm just like trying to keep it on a blessed level still.
We're not
a black white thing, because we've got black listeners and white listeners.
We've got multiracial.
Yeah, but in case you don't know this, but I've seen it. I've been to all white area. But in there, yeah, you can say mixed race. But in here, in black, mainly black areas, yeah, mixed race might mean half white, half black, yeah. But if you go to other areas, yeah, just, you know, having, you know, being non-white, you know, even having a tint of black in you, yeah, they're not going to accept you. You have to be 110% white. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Right. I don't agree with you there, though, still, but...
Yeah, no. No, but any day, yeah, I've been to areas, yeah, where even though, like, you can be mixed race, yeah, you still get looked down on, if you know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
Yeah, we know.
Like, a white person might say, oh, look at that nigga, even though the person's mixed race. It's just that, you know, you're not 100% white.
Nah, but the way I'm seeing it is this. In every race, you got the couple of individuals that behave in that manner, but there are good people in every race.
No,
but the more we say black this and black that, we isolate ourselves from other cultures.
Yeah,
do you get me? Because if I was to say Asian this or black that, and I'm isolating myself from the community, do you get me? So the more everyone says us people are getting hurt, us people are getting hurt, the more you push yourself. But if we say we're all getting hurt, then we can move forward as a group. Do you get what I'm saying?
No, but that's not fair because you see, that's not what I mean. You've been brainwashed already, haven't you? Because you're only talking about. Because how come they don't highlight the naughty white kids and naughty Asian kids?
There's a lot of naughty white, there's a lot of naughty white, black kids,
there's
yellow.
Some good white kids as well.
Yeah, but it's what I'm saying is, it's true what Navy said. You're taking yourself away from other people.
The more you say black this, black that, black this, black that, you're pushing yourself
away.
And you're giving them a reason to say black this, black that. Because you're saying black this, black
that. You get me?
But if you say, boy, I see some good in you and I see some bad in you, same as I see good in us, then we work as a team to fix the good in you and you fix the good in them. Do you get it?
Yeah, but you can't say that one day, you're talking about that, but in case... If you go to most secondary schools...
Yeah, if you go to most secondary school, go to most public schools, not private schools, go to most public schools, you will find a mixture of both black and white kids, Asian, Arab, everything being good and bad.
Simple. You get me?
Yeah, I know that. Yeah, but remember this, take every single one of them races, and like imagine put the white mixtures or Asian and black together, like separately, and half them into good and black, then you tell me which one's going to be in the newspaper for if one of them, if we have done black.
Only reason going to be in the newspaper. Only the reason they're in the newspaper is because you separated them and you said us black kids are bad. Or us Asian, because they're going to be in them, because then you just gave them a reason to point at you.
By separating them.
By separating,
simple.
We all live in an urban area, do you get me?
No. Because what they're doing is, I do sociology. What happens is they're lying about all these things, all these statistics, The media just take statistics and play with them. No one had done last time, I think it was your son, that all black people commit crime. I'm just taking statistics from majorly, black area sort of thing.
Yeah,
family.
Yeah, okay. We understand.
So let's see what the family says about what you have to say,
What?
Let's see what the family has to say about what you've just said, Because you said a lot of points, So we want to hear what anybody else has to say about what you've just said,
Yeah.
Alright.
You play Eve Love is Blind.
Yeah, we're going to play that.
We're waiting for that,
Right. Not, next tune is yours, not in this one. The tune after I'm going to play for you.
Okay.
Alright.
Bless.
All right, bless.
Right, shout out to the last caller. Shout out to the 380. Bless.
Yeah,
bless.
Yeah, what you say?
What's your name? Where you calling from?
About the black school thing, One of the reasons why black people are underachieving. Because of the media,
Right.
Every time you turn on the TV, and see a black kid, see a black person on TV. Can you hear me?
They're
telling jokes, you get me? Or they're singing a song, or they're dancing. Every time a black person on TV opens up their mouth, it's followed by canned laughter. You know what I mean?
That's a character, though. That's not to do with the black
person.
Yeah,
but you know where it is,
Truthfully,
I see where you're coming from, but it's all about if you were to acknowledge that. You see what I'm saying? Because whatever they're showing on TV, they're saying, well, boy, I can do this and do that. But it takes time to get where they are. You see what I'm saying? It's not easy. And they're flossing because it's tax money. The reason why you see all Ja Rule, all 50 them, all ICE and everything, is because it's all tax money. Because if they don't use that money, tax man will take that money. See what I'm saying?
That's
how it runs. Because on videos and everything, all them videos, there's truth what Navy said. It's a character. That's their character. Because at home, they're not really like that. You see what I'm saying?
No. I'm saying about TV. When you turn on the TV,
right?
When you turn on the TV, you don't see no black people talking no sense. You don't see, you hardly see any black people talking in the news.
Oh, I know what you're talking about.
The white people. You know what I mean?
Right.
Yeah.
There's all these black comedy shows, so the black kids watch that, watch the shows, yeah, and they think, they go to school thinking they got to impress the white kids and make everyone laugh. Because that's what they see their people doing.
So what, you're saying...
What you're saying?
No, the saying is, I'm to understand what you're saying, I understand, but what you're telling me, that's why they underachieve.
I think that's one of the reasons why, yeah, because that's how they see their people on TV.
I see what you're saying. They still seem positive.
They never see their people in the government. They don't see their people reading out the news. They got that one bread reading out the news. Yeah.
But you got a lot of black people out there. You just got to look. There's a lot of Lambie, innit?
Yeah, look at them tennis players.
Them tennis players. There's a lot of black people achieving, but when you look at them, people don't say, oh, they're going to say they're not black. They're going to say, oh, they wasn't raising my community.
But you know what it is, people seeing that, but they're doing good. You see what I'm saying? You got to acknowledge that they're doing good. You see what I'm saying?
It's easier to acknowledge somebody that's catching joke than somebody that's telling you politics about your area where you live or reading the news to you.
He's got a point, though.
No, he's got a point.
It's good, because on the television is big joke and laughter.
But what I'm saying is this.
Why can't we have a show where they're showing their positive things and constructive things that we need to know?
Yeah, true.
They're never talking sense on TV. They're just talking some joke thing.
Yeah,
that's true, man. I agree with that.
But
no, you don't say what I'm saying.
But there's a way, there's a way. But if that is if they want to do that, you see what I'm saying? Because... we're saying that they should do that, but that is if they want to really take it on and do it. You see what I'm saying?
What are you talking about?
What I'm saying is...
no, the other people that's messing up.
What are you talking about?
I don't know what he's talking about.
No, what I'm saying is,
you lot are just trying to get me, man.
I understand where he's coming from about the shows and everything, But there are some black males that are doing good for the community, but you just don't look at them the same way as you look at somebody that's catching joke. Do you get what I'm saying? Somebody might be telling you a joke and you'd be like, laughed at. But somebody might be on the other side telling you, boy, this is happening in my community. But you're not really going to pay attention to him because he's not giving you jokes. You just have to look. So it depends on the individual. If he looks at the person that's giving him laughter, you can't blame the person on TV, innit? You have to blame the individual.
Telling, giving you laughter, then they are talking sense.
Yeah, that's true. But there's a lot of films out there. In a lot of black video shops, if you go in them shops, you will find bare positive black people saying positive messages.
You've got to go to them shops and find them. They ain't there. They ain't advertised.
Yeah, but still, sometimes you have to seek and find, you know, because if we was to get everything that we wanted on the television and get everything, you know how large or how the things will be. So we have to try harder and find the information that we need to know.
For real.
We have to find it. It's not going to come on a plate. No,
they ain't on that, man. They ain't on that. They're on switching on the TV and looking on the TV and seeing what they see, isn't
it? Yeah, I know, but they don't think about going to find deeper than what they see on the television. See, so that's why we have to go and find the information in the black bookshops and stuff.
It's been like that. They've been degrading black people by the TV. They've got to be dancing and singing. And that's what they think, that's what they can do, and that's what they got to grow up to be. They don't see themselves on some high-up job and think, that's going to be me, because they hardly ever see that.
That's a good point.
Yeah, you got a good point, man. Big up yourself for that.
Yes.
What's your name, where you calling from?
Yeah, DJ Farrell.
From where?
Farmers Green.
Farmers Green.
DJ for real.
DJ for real?
Yeah.
You're a DJ. See, what do you play?
R&B hip hop.
See. Okay. Sounds interesting. All right.
Still, man.
Hold
on, you man. Still.
Were you on a radio station or something?
No, I ain't even. You know, I should be there still.
Oh, what radio stations are?
I ain't on a radio station, but I should be.
All right, then. We'll prepare a CD or a mini disc or something. Yeah.
Bring in a CD.
No, send in a mini disc, or when you've done a CD or a mini disc or something.
I've got all that.
Alright, then we'll have to take that from you sometime during the week, say Saturday or Saturday.
What do I do with his number?
Yeah.
Texting your number and someone.
No, we just phone in on Saturday and somebody will just come and link you for it, yeah?
Alright.
Because you got a good point there, you know, with a head like that, you're supposed to have some good tunes and play some positive tunes.
Yeah, yeah.
So you can't be playing tunes with mother effing this and that, and then you're just talking like this a minute ago. See what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Ah, then bless.
Bless.
You laugh, innit?
Right, shout out to Shanice, yeah? 271, bless.
Yeah, it's me again. I just want to say, what the other person said here, yeah, the person, the other caller said, no, but he did kind of contradict himself, because he said that, you know, oh, all black people might be seen as, you know, just entertainers, but, you know, a DJ. He said it's all about self-choice. You can see it. Just because you see it on TV don't mean you have to be. They're there to entertain you. The white entertainers, the black entertainers, you're there, they're just to entertain you, but you can go back to college and do something and up yourself as well. So he's talking about just that. I'm thinking, in a way, no offense to him, but, you know, you can't really sit there and say, oh, people are just only entertainers, yeah.
No,
and
but he was saying, yourself. What he was saying, yeah, is that if you switch on the TV, yeah, you'll find more, like, comedies for the black youths or males or women or whatever.
Oh, no.
You weren't really saying...
that's not true, no way. Because then they ask a war, come now, yeah? Hello? Oh, don't think they hang up for me, okay?
No, go on.
What?
Go through.
Because then they, if you think about it, yeah, so that black people are very lovely and happy people, and they... Well, you know, I think black people are more into comedy and sort of thing. You know, in a way, you know, the racism that they make, you know, laughter is a funny thing, because, you know, it kind of builds barriers, really. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
And comedy, yeah, you see, like, fresh meat to play and stuff like that, you know, the racism is, like, sort of, like, expressed through it and the stereotypes, you know. But then in Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, not all of them are DJs, rappers, and with that, and that, a fat bloke, don't know what his name is, he's a barrister, ain't he?
Yeah.
You know what I'm talking about, really? That people aren't seeing is that what you want to see and then you want to absorb. You get it?
Yeah,
like, Jerrell is an entertainer, but also Jerrell is a human being afterwards.
Yeah.
You're not really going to sit there and say, oh, Jerrell, oh, it's all about the living. You know, some people are just not realistic, no offense.
Right.
You can't really believe that Jerrell, yeah, wakes up in the morning, yeah, to shout, yeah, and then put, you know, and just walks around in some golden slippers.
That's a good point. That's
you know what I'm
point.
Talking about?
Yeah, true. Yeah.
In a way, is that realistic in self-interpretation? It's all like a TV program. Don't even want to copy it. I mean, you know, you're going to be forced into
At a young age, yeah, you're more influenced by TV, especially at a younger age. If it's on TV, then you most likely will end up, not most likely, but it's got a stronger chance influencing you.
By the night trainers and stuff. But think of it this way, yeah, if you're talking about that, just like I'm saying myself in participation, you can have a rap CD and a racist CD, yeah. Don't tell me that child's gonna shop, yeah. I'm gonna buy every CD that it's stored on TV. No, it's only gonna buy the CD that he wants. You get me?
Yeah.
So it's about self, you know, it's a common sense self interpretation. Because if you're trainers, if you, let me see, if you're going to pink shoes and blue shoes or something, yeah, you can't tell me just because you saw the pink shoes advertised, you're going to buy 6 pairs of the pink shoes. You won't.
No, what?
The self interpretation, exactly.
Alright. You got a good point.
Yes, I have.
Can
you play Eve
out? Yeah, I'm going to do that. Is in the CD? Is there? But she's not. All right. Shout out to Hattie. Unfortunately, we ain't got that with us, you know. Shout out to all the Edmonton Massive, yeah? Shout out to Sweetlips. Right, shout out to Shanice, yeah. Shout out to Jada, all at Edmonton Massive.
Okay. Right, we know about the politics. We know about what we're doing. Some of us do. What can we do to make it better?
I don't even know you and I hate you. See, all I know is that my girlfriend used to date you. How would you feel if she held you down and raped you?
079-444-31366.
Then I'd ask you half. I mean, why? What kind of love from a nigga would black your eye? What kind of love from a nigga every night make you cry? What kind of love from a nigga make you wish he would die? I mean, shit, he bought you things and gave you diamond rings, but them things wasn't worth none of the pain that he brings. You stayed. What made you fall? For him, that nigga had the power to make you fall for him. I thought you was a doctor, be on call for him. Smacked you down cause he said you was too tall for him, huh? That wasn't love, baby girl, you was dreaming. I could have killed you when you said your seed was growing.
Bless.
And can you not, like, when you're playing this song, can you not, like, let no one interrupt it, yeah? And when you finish playing, can you repeat again?
Why, we've got to answer the phone, you know.
Isn't it?
Yes, but just one song.
We've got to answer the phone.
Just one song.
Well, you interrupted it. You're the only ones who interrupted it.
It.
No, just let me record this one song, okay?
Record it?
Yeah.
Boy, you know what? Can't do well, nothing
now,
about
play,
that.
Man. We'll do it. Let's play. We'll just play the tune. Yeah, if the phone rings, it rings, though.
Yeah.
Yeah, we can't switch the phone off because that's disrespect to the family, yeah?
Yeah, you've done that.
I'm a part. Can you just stop live calling?
No, 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 can't do that.
No.
Oh, that's deep.
Can't do that.
Because supposing somebody else said that and you wanted to come and say what you just said.
Fine, then can you just rewind it to the beginning?
Yes, we can do that for you. But we're not going to talk, though. But okay. Well. Yeah, well, this one goes out to the last caller, yeah? Well, as far as I'm concerned, we're all family, yeah? And we all have to answer to one creator at the end of the day. So we all gotta live good, yeah?
Hey yo, I don't even know you and I hate you. See, all I know is that my girlfriend used to date you. How would you feel if she held you down and raped you? Tried and tried, but she never could escape you. She was in love, and I'd ask her half. I mean, why? What kind of love from a nigga would black your eye? What kind of love from a nigga every night make you cry? What kind of love from a nigga make you wish she would die? I mean, shit,
straight up, Miss Cooling Crew.
Gave you diamond rings.
Bless.
Yeah, yeah. You get me?
Huh?
Just did that to interrupt for the last caller. She wanted to talk all that time and then tell nobody to interrupt.
It's cool, man, but it's blessed, though, man. You get me?
Yeah.
You see it? Blessed.
Man. She said.
Huh?
Talking about I punched it myself.
It's cool, man. Don't.
He's
saying about contradicts himself. That's what last
caller said. Blessed, though. We all keep it blessed. Man. Everybody's allowed to contradict themselves, but somebody will come back and correct them. If they, you know what I mean?
He's enough.
Yeah, it's blessed, definitely, man. It's blessed. All right.
Okay.
What?
You fall for him. That nigga had the power to make you.
Hey, you got Big T.
Shout goes out to Baby Z and Jada, yeah?
Bless.
You know, everyone's got different point of views, you know. Doesn't mean, just because it doesn't, that's whatever someone's saying, just because it doesn't conform to whatever you think, doesn't mean they're contradicting themselves, okay? They could believe something else, you could believe something else. Doesn't mean they're contradicting themselves.
That's true.
It's true, man.
Just gotta put that out there.
Yeah, that's cool.
Bless. Hattie locked on.
That wasn't love, baby girl, you was dreaming. I could have killed you when you said your seed was growing from the seed.
It's blind, and it'll take over your mind. What you think is love, it's truly not. You need to elevate and find. It's blind, and it'll take over your mind. What you think is love, it's truly not. You need to elevate and find. When I kill you myself, you played with her like a doll and put her back on the shelf. Wouldn't let her go to school and better herself. She had to make ass and you ain't giving no help for her. Big time hustler, snake motherfucker. One's born every day and
hey, you know what? You know, we're gonna cut this tune.
Yeah. We're not into the swearing thing, you know.
Trust me.
Yeah, if I did not have swearing in it, I would have said, nah, nah, nah.
No.
We're not into that.
You ready, B?
Let's
go again. Look for me, young B, cruising down the west side highway, doing what we like to do. Highway, eyes behind shades, this necklace, the reason all of my days been blind.
Bless.
Yeah, hi, it's me again. Before you go, can you play Eve, Love is Blind again?
It's got swearing.
It's got swearing, we can't play it.
Oh, that's the, no, because it's past for that thing, 9 o'clock.
All right, then what's the name of the radio station?
Bless, innit?
Right, so where does the swearing fit into it?
Oh, that's deep, you know, because then it's good swearing there, because it's sort of like,
it's not good swearing.
Oh, it's good swearing, yeah? Hold on, no, it's good swearing, yeah?
No. This also, stop trying to use my words against me. It's not like, you know, what?
No, go on,
you said something?
No, go on.
It's not exactly lyrics, you know, trying to tell someone, oh, go and tab up everyone here. It's just like sort of anger lyrics sort of thing, if you know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, but that kind of, that's not how you talk to someone.
That's deep.
No, that's not deep, man.
So can I ask you a question?
What?
So when I'm, like, angry or feeling something, am I allowed to swear because it's good swearing?
No, I mean, I'm not telling you to go out and swear, but you know how, like, what?
Swearing is swearing, yeah?
Swearing.
No, but what I'm saying is, you know, in a record, yeah, if a record has, like, a lot of shouting or swearing or something, yeah, but, you know, it's not coming out in you, yeah, but the record, the anger's coming out from the record, not from you. And like, you know, oh, can you just play again, please?
Alright, so if your little sister or brother came to you and talked to you like that, it'd be alright then, yeah?
Yeah, but they ain't gonna talk to me like that.
No, but it's just...
Look, are you gonna just start attacking me?
Alright, no, but here's one.
It's just lyrics, yeah? Okay, when you finish listening to the record, you're not gonna start mimicking it, are you?
No, I don't agree with you.
No, here's one. So what? Is it okay for me to rob a bank if I'm poor?
What?
Is it okay for me to rob a bank if I'm poor? Yeah. Because it's good, isn't it? Because I'm poor.
Well, there's two different things to saying that. You know, everyone's going to start saying I'm contradicting myself.
No, we're not going to contradict you no more. All we're going to say is this, yeah? We don't play tunes with swearing in it, yeah? And you're telling us that we must do it for you.
Okay, because this is... It's like,
that's what you're saying.
The swear word bits, then.
We don't know where it is. I just heard it. I don't even know where it is in the tune. I don't even know the tune.
I'm swearing.
I don't even know. That's what I'm saying.
Just play half of it.
Oh, I can't do that. You already got half of it, though.
No, where it is, yeah, because we're blessed. You get? We got little youths listening. We can't risk that little swearing, even if we knew where it was.
Sorry.
It's not even you, stuff. I've got my parents locked in. We've got older generation locked in. You see what I'm saying?
Your parents